Afternoon, everyone. Let me look for my 5-minute timer. There it is, and I'm on. I've been giving you 5 minutes to talk to you about threat modeling, so we're gonna get right into it. Threat modeling is the idea of taking something and breaking it down into its component parts and applying a structured model of analyzing threats. And what that means is we have these three parts where we map a data flow, we break it down to trust boundaries, and then we apply a threat model. And the threat model we're talking about today is stride analysis. I like it, so we're gonna use it. There are 6 controls here, and these are the controls we'll use. We have spoofing, which is basically pretending to be something. Tampering, which is against integrity, so if someone makes changes to your code. We have repudiation, which is basically the reputation of information you have. Information disclosure, which is the loss of IPR. Denial of service, which is exactly what it says on the tin, and elevation of privilege. And these are the 6 controls we have to consider when doing threat modeling. The interesting thing about Stride is it was invented in 1999. So that's where we're gonna look at it first, with the data flow diagram. But a caveat about me, I was 12 years old in 1999, so I wasn't part of the professional IT scene. I was mostly playing video games and skipping homework. So we're gonna look through the cultural lens of Friends and Frasier. Now, I assume this is how data flow happened in the 90s. You had a developer who goes to a coffee shop to hand over his code to the ops guy on a floppy disk that I remember were about this big. I might be wrong, I may have grown since then. And he will put it in his car, he'll take it to a server, the server will have the software installed. This is the data flow. And then we have trust boundaries. So if you notice here, the trust boundaries are wherever the software moves or changes hands, changes control. And this can be on an interface level, it can be a process level, or it can be on a system level. And then simply we apply the threat model. So spoofing, can the identity of the developer and the operations guy be established? Information disclosure, is someone listening? Tampering, can someone take the floppy disk out of the car? It's quite simple. And now it's 2024. So how has it changed in 25 years? And we can just say that it hasn't. It's just got a lot more complicated. Here's the data flow diagram that hopefully looks familiar for a lot of you. We have a developer who puts his code into a repository and it goes through pipelines, it comes out to be stored, and it goes onto a cluster where it's served. It's a very simple pipeline system. But this is the modern one, and it's more complex. So we end up with a trust boundary system that looks like this. It looks like a unicorn has vomited on it. That's to be expected, but these are the trust boundaries that we now have. We have them as it shifts data, as the controller of data changes, and that's the crucial thing to think about. And how this works, I now have a minute and 40 left, so I'm going to do some of the stride analysis on these trust boundaries. Not all of them, because that will take too much time. Source code repository. This is where your code's stored. So spoofing might be spoofing the entire system and having people push code there. Tampering might be someone has altered your code, they've added repositories or dependencies that you don't want there. Repudiation always comes down to logging properly. And if you log properly, repudiation is not a problem. Information disclosure is the loss of IPR, so your code gets stolen. Denial of service is that you can't reach the service and no work happens. Elevation is privilege, is someone logging in that you don't want to. And this is the whole process throughout threat modeling, and we comply everywhere, like pipelines. The same thing, spoofing, maybe get it to pull from a repository that's not yours. Tampering, interfere in the build process, adding your own code or your own dependencies to the system. Repudiation is always logging. Information disclosure, perhaps someone passes information out from the system. Denial of service, the pipelines go down. Elevation of privilege, someone does something on your pipeline system you don't want them to. And we do this throughout the entire tool chain. Another interesting one is storage, where you have spoofed credentials, you might have tampering, changing of local images. But this is the whole process as we go through. Communications interfaces, very similar. We just apply that structured model. And then, of course, we have mitigation, because this is just the thought process. you have to mitigate, you have to iterate, and you have to validate what you've been doing. And that's all.